Hi friends, this is Soft Reason. You are welcome. In this lesson, we will be adding rebar to the foundation. This one, and as well to the column. Okay, but before we proceed, I will want you to like the lesson, subscribe as well. And stay tuned for more advanced lesson. Okay, so let's go into the lesson. All right, so I will navigate to the south elevation, just like this. Okay, and then after which I will activate the structural tab, just like this, and I will check my cover. Okay. If I select this, okay, I'll be able to check my cover. Yeah, my cover is 40 mm, okay, which is for the foundation. Okay, so I will click on outside, okay, and then modify, then activate the rebar. Okay, click OK. In the rebar browser, I will be using choosing this rebar, okay, this one. Okay, I'll be choosing this one. Okay, so I've selected this one already. So if you check here, see the properties here, it is M13, the diameter is 13. For the sake of this lesson, we'll be using this. Okay, I've taught how to edit this one in one of the lessons. Okay, so we'll be using this one. Okay, so I will come to this point and I'll place it just like this. Okay, now you have to consider my setting. Okay, so if you come to this placement, the first placement is near cover reference. Okay, that should be your setting, because if you set it otherwise, it may not, you may not have this result. Okay, so the second one is parallel to work plane. Okay, so make sure that your setting are in this format. All right, so let's proceed. So after which I will click on modify, then I will select the rebar, okay, just like this, and then select this place. You go to maximum, then the spacing of the rebar I will make it 150. Okay, then I click in here. All right, so it's been generated towards this direction at 150 spacing, and altogether there are 9 bars here. Okay. Alright, so the next thing I will do, I will go to the west direction. In this direction, I will also activate the rebar. And I will also place it here in this direction. Okay. After which, I will click on modify. And then I'll select the rebar, and then I do the same thing. All right, so after which I can now navigate to the 3D to see what I've done so far. Okay, so if I click here to view it, you see you have something like this. Okay, so this is the rebar at the foundations. Okay, so the next thing we will be looking at, we'll be looking at adding rebar to the column. Okay, so for us to do that, we need to navigate to the normal ground level, this one. So double click here, this will take you to this normal ground level. So at this normal ground level, if you want to add a rebar just the way it is, you have issues because it's going to snap the foundation surface. Okay, so for us to bypass that issue, we need to hide the foundation this foundation. Okay, we need to hide it. Okay, for instance, if I activate this, you can see that I wanted to place rebar. This is the column, this blue area is the column, but I can't place it in the column because it is snapping and taking the foundation as the work plane. Okay, so you click on modify, you select the foundation just like this, right click, and then you click on hide element, so you will not see the foundation. The same thing you will do to the base plate and the board, because we are adding reinforcement to this column, this blue area. Okay, so I will highlight this one just like this, just like this. Okay, and then I will right click and click on hide element, so I will hide this one. Now I'm having only the column, so I cannot add my reinforcement to the column. Okay, so I'll go to rebar. I click on rebar. So in the rebar browser, the rebar I will be using in this case is going to be the rebar we'll be looking at in this case. Let me check. Okay, I will be using this one. Okay, this one. So I will select it and then come to this point. You see the way it is snapping, this is not actually what I wanted. Okay, so I will come to this place and then I will select parallel to cover. Okay, then I will check. All right, so this is actually what I wanted. Okay, so I will have to zoom it such a way that I see it very well. Okay, so you can use the space bar to know the side of the rebar. So I cannot place it like this. Okay, just like this, after which I will escape and adjust this rebar. Okay, you can see this one is the length. Okay, while this is the main longer side, this is the shorter side at the foundation. So I will bring it to this point just like this. Okay, I'll bring it up to this point. Alright, so what I will do, I will navigate to the 3D just like this. I want to check this rebar, so I will highlight this the column, and then I will go to the south elevation. So this is the rebar. Okay, this one. So I will highlight it. After highlighting it, I will click on it and be able to adjust it down just like this. Okay, so I want to do something here. Okay, so I want to select this foundation. Okay, right click and then use override graphic category, and then I will have to reduce the transparency. Click on apply and okay. So I will be having something of this kind. Okay, so I can extend this one to some extent just like this, then I use this place to bring it down on this point. So I'm having something like this. This is actually what I expected. Okay, so I will now be going back to the normal ground level. Okay, just like this. Okay, so after which I will mirror this one. Okay, so I will click on mirror this point, and then I'll click on this point. All right, so I'm now having something this way and that way. Okay, so what I will want to do now is I will click and then adjust this point to this extent. Okay, and also adjust this to some extent here just like this. Okay, so I will also move this out of this point just a little bit, just like this. Okay, using the arrow key, and I'll do the same thing here. Okay, using the arrow key. All right, just like this. So I will hold the control key so I can be able to select these two together. All right, so I intended to have 6 numbers of bars in these columns. Okay, so I will have one at this edge, one at the center, and then one at this edge. So I will now click on copy. Okay, just like this, and then I will copy it, move it to this center point and click. Okay, and also move it here And then click just like this. Okay, I click on modify. All right, so mind you, you should make sure that it's actually in line. Okay, so I'll have to select and do a little adjustment using the arrow key on the keyboard, just like this. All right, so I will navigate to the 3D and then I'll select this to see what I've done so far. So this is a what I have done. Okay, so I can highlight this one and this one. Okay, then right click and then go to the overall graphic by category. Okay, then I will redo the transparency so you can see what we have been doing so far. Okay, all right, so this is what we are having here, you can see. All right, so this is it. All right, so the next thing we'll be adding a shear reinforcement to it. Okay, shear reinforcement. So for us to do that, we also navigate to the normal ground level. We will go to the structural tab and activate the rebar. Okay, just like this. All right, so we will scroll down to see okay, we will be using this one. Okay, select this, but we will reduce this to this diameter. Okay, and then we will bring it here. You can see it is not really giving us what we expected. So what I will do is I'll come to this place and then I will use parallel to plane. So this is what I actually expected. Okay, so I will click on this. All right, so if you notice that this bar is actually directly on this one, the column rebar. So I will use the space bar, sorry, the arrow key to adjust it just like this. Okay, I think this one is okay, so I will do the same thing here so I can have it in the exact location. Just like this. Okay, I'll also adjust this one. All right, so this is okay like this. So the next thing I will have to do is I will navigate to the 3D. So if you check it, you see the bar somewhere here. This place, see it here. Okay, so what I will do is, okay, it's here, sorry, see it here. So what I will do is I will go to the south elevations. And this south elevations, I'll be able to select the bar. Okay, once I select it, I'm supposed to generate it, but in this case I'm not going to generate, but I'm going to copy it. Okay, so I click on copy, then click on multiple as well as constraint, just like this, and then you click on this point, take it here. Okay, just like this. Okay, you can't be able to maintain the space. The spacing I'm maintaining here is 100. Okay, for the sake of the lesson, we are using 100 spacing. Okay, so you still select and then copy. Alright, so you click on modify. Alright, so you can now navigate to the 3D. Alright, just like this to see what you have done so far. Alright, so you can see the reinforcement has been placed successfully. Okay, so if you go to the plan view, you will notice that the foundation is not showing in the normal ground level. So for us to bring it out from hidden, you click this point. Okay, once you click this point, what you need to do is you click this foundation, but by Before then, I would like us to bring this extension and the anchor bolt. Okay, so we will select that. Okay, hold the control key, select this one as well, right click. Okay, and then on height element you click here, so they are no longer hidden again. Okay, to do the same thing to this one, the foundation, right click, and then click on like height element, just like this. Okay, and then click on this point. Alright, so you notice that it's now in place. Okay, so you can now navigate to the 3D to see what you have done. Okay, so far, so this is what we have done. Alright, so this is how you can add reinforcement or rebar to your foundations. Okay, for presentations. Okay, and then for implementations at the site. So you can also increase the level of reduce the level of transparency. Okay, just like this, so you are having something of this kind. Okay, so this is what the lesson of today is all about. I believe you have learned one or two things. In the next lesson, we'll be doing detailing of this reinforcement, so you have to stay tuned. If you have not subscribed, subscribe, like the lesson. You can share it as well to your friends that may be in need of it. Okay, also make sure that you stay tuned for more advanced lesson. Okay, bye for now.